Hey everyone, welcome to the first episode of my Skylanders feature. In this series, I'll focus on Skylanders' release for Skylanders SuperChargers, and we're going to take a look at their attacks, upgrades, strategies, and my overall opinions on them. And for the debut episode of the series, we're going to take a look at a SuperCharger that's a guest character and is exclusive to the Nintendo versions of the game, Turbocharged Donkey Kong.
Turbocharged Donkey Kong.
Okay, cool. Turbocharged Donkey Kong. DK, along with his signature vehicle, the Barrel Blaster, is found in the standard edition of the starter pack for the Wii U. A double pack containing DK and the Barrel Blaster were recently announced as well, so you can buy them separately if you want. Dark Turbocharged Donkey Kong and the Dark Barrel Blaster, which are variants of the regular versions, are currently available in the Wii U Dark Edition starter pack. And Donkey Kong, along with the other guest character, Hammer Slam Bowser, and I'll do a video of him some other time, only work with the Wii U, 3DS, and Wii versions. They do not work with any other version. In addition, he and Bowser have dual functionality as a Skylander and an amiibo. To change the setting, all you have to do is tilt the base at the bottom to switch between Skylander mode and amiibo mode. And if you use Turbocharged Donkey Kong as an amiibo in an amiibo-compatible game, he shows up as a regular Donkey Kong figure. Okay, now back to the game. Some quick stats. Donkey Kong is of the life element, and the Barrel Blaster is a tech element vehicle. Donkey Kong has a nice combination of close-up attacks, range attacks, and also another attack form, Super Donkey Kong. We'll get to all of that in a bit, but first let's take a look at his basic attacks and his upgrades. Okay, like any other Skylander, he only starts out with two attacks, and before we go through them, I do want to note that Donkey Kong is pretty much fully upgraded here, so some of the attacks might look a little bit different than they actually will be when you first start upgrading him. But anyway, the first attack here is Primate Punch. Press Y rapidly to perform melee attacks. Okay, so he does like a four-hit combo, so one punch and three swipes at the barrel. There we go. That's a pretty decent attack. There we go. Okay, the next one, Barrel Toss. Press A to throw your barrels at nearby enemies. If they get too close, you'll smash them with the barrel instead. Okay, so this is an upgraded barrel, that's why it has spikes on it, but otherwise it's just going to look like a regular barrel. So it does have really good range. Oh, let me pick these up real quick. You can throw it at the dummy here. So yeah, if you get up close, you see it, he like spikes it down like a football. Okay, and his third attack is the first one that you buy. Bongo Barrel. Press X rapidly to slam your barrel down and use it as a bongo. Use your bongos to damage nearby enemies. When you stop, your bongo will continue to play for a short time. Okay, so tapping X plays the bongos and you can damage enemies, and you can leave it alone and it'll continue to play for a little bit. Oh, there you go. It is stronger when Donkey Kong is playing it. It only does a little bit of damage when you're not playing it anymore, but you know, it's an okay attack overall. I mean, it's good for like big enemies that don't move around that much. You can play that and, you know, maybe throw some barrels at it. Super Donkey Kong. This is the transformation I was talking about earlier. Hold Y to enter Super Donkey Kong mode. When in Super Donkey Kong mode, press X to stomp and A to do a barrel roll. Now, I do want to point this out real quick. As I'm demonstrating these attacks, they're both like kind of upgraded because he's on that upgrade path. So they're going to look a little different from when you first upgrade him. Okay, so hold in Y and he transforms. So he has barrels on his fists. And his melee attack is actually different now too. It's actually pretty strong. Okay, and also said to hit A, go into a barrel and roll over enemies. Oh, let me start that over again. So yeah, like I said, the little light barrel that comes out of it, that's part of an upgrade. And then you can hit X to stomp. Yeah, and the girders that are falling, that's part of an upgrade too. But yeah, those girders are supposed to be from the original Donkey Kong, I guess, because that's what they look like in that game. Next up is Barrels of Fun. Charge up A and release to be put into an arrow barrel. While in the barrel, you'll be able to aim around the level and shoot yourself, causing an explosion where you land. Okay, so you can aim it as you're holding A, and then you can let go and shoot down. Truthfully, I don't usually use this attack, but it does have its uses. As you can see, it's pretty strong, and when you slam down, it does have a pretty decent size area of effect. It can hit multiple enemies. Okay, old school, we just saw that. That's the one where all the girders fall from the sky in Super Donkey Kong mode when you tap X. Okay, for those that don't know, for Skylanders, they all have two upgrade paths. So, previously, you could only take one upgrade path. But starting in this game, when you reach Portal Master rank 74, you can actually switch between the two. Previously, only Series 2 and higher characters could do that, but now anybody can do that once you reach that rank. If a character has a variant, I tend to pick one upgrade path on the regular one, and the variant will have another path, just so, you know, they're different. So, Dark Donkey Kong is on the top path, and the regular one is going to be on the bottom path, and I'll show both paths too. Okay, so the first one here, Boom Barrels. Tapping A will now throw explosive barrels. So, as you can see, he has a TNT barrel now, and they explode, so these are stronger. It's actually pretty fun to use too. And then when you go up close, you slam it down too. Looks like for about the same damage. Explosive landing. Charge up A and release to be shot around in a barrel. That's a typo. It should be A barrel, not N barrel. Anyway, at the end of the move, you'll now trigger a big explosion. Okay, let's check this out. So hold an A and pick a target. I'm gonna land on the dummy. There we go. So yeah, that's obviously a lot stronger than it was. There we go. That's pretty cool. Bongo Blast. Press X rapidly to start playing the bongos. Bongos that are left behind now explode. There we go. So he's playing bongos on a TNT barrel this time. When you let go, it plays on its own, like usual. You can attack while that's going on. And now it explodes. Actually, let me show that again, because I was kind of messing around. There we go. Okay, now let's go over the bottom path. Spiky barrels. Tapping A will now throw spiky barrels. Also, Super Donkey Kong mode will use spiked barrels to attack enemies. Okay, I've shown that already, but I can show that again real quick. So yeah, he punches with the spiked barrels. And also, his A attack is in a spiked barrel as well instead of just a regular one. And he'll throw the spiked barrels. Okay, barrel rolled. Hold Y to enter Super Donkey Kong mode, press A while in Super Donkey Kong mode to roll over nearby enemies in a huge spiked barrel. Okay, I kind of showed this already, but I can show it again real quick. But yeah, this is a really quick attack that can help in a bind, because it rolls over multiple enemies that are right in front of you. And farther away ones with this upgrade. Okay, Healthy Kong. Regenerate health while in Super Donkey Kong mode. Okay, I can't show this one here, but when you're in Super Donkey Kong mode, you actually heal until the timer runs out. So this is actually a really, really good upgrade. Okay, and last but not least, this is Diddy You Call. This is the Soul Gem attack for Turbocharged Donkey Kong, and you need to unlock this before you can actually buy it. And in this game, Soul Gems are randomly found in treasure chests, that you can find them in the Academy, in the Well, stuff like that. Okay, Diddy You Call. Tap X to build up a power meter. When filled, you will call in Diddy Kong to fly around on his jetpack and attack nearby enemies. Okay, let's build up this meter. This is what I was trying not to do earlier. But yeah, when you tap X a bunch of times, then he shows up and he'll shoot enemies with his peanut pop gun. Pretty cool. And you can also turn into Super Donkey Kong and attack enemies while he's doing that. So this is a really good soul gem. And he stays, as you can see, he stays in for quite a while too. Okay, we're going to check out some gameplay of both paths, but first I'm going to check out the top path with Dark Donkey Kong. So yeah, this is my favorite chapter to go through and test out attacks and stuff like that, because there's so many enemies that show up here. Since it's an arena, you can pretty much just test out whatever you want here. Okay, so let's check out some of the gameplay of the top path. So yeah, you can hit enemies from afar with the TNT barrels, and it's pretty strong. Or you can get up close and hit them with that, too. Let's build up the bongos. Oh, he's gone. Well, here's Brimstone. So yeah, Diddy Kong and Donkey Kong together are a really good combination. As you can see, it was just like hit after hit if you do the combo here. Yeah, let's dodge all these. This fight has really good music. Okay, now we have two of them at once. Actually, I want to build up Donkey Kong, or Diddy Kong, excuse me. Ooh, got a little too close there. You can transform it into the Super Donkey Kong mode, but there's not really much of a benefit with doing that. If you like transforming into Super Donkey Kong, you definitely want to pick the other path. And if you like using just regular Donkey Kong, the TNT path is a lot better. Okay, let's fight Captain Bristlestache and his team. Oh, he almost got me. There we go. So yeah, this is a good test to see how Skylanders can perform against big groups, because these guys, yeah, because you get surrounded here a lot, and the grenades will try to jump on you. So yeah, it's a good test to see how you can handle groups of enemies. There we go. Nice. Okay, the captain, yep, he's coming in. Actually, something I haven't demonstrated yet is the explosive barrel here. So yeah, it hits twice on the way down. It's actually really strong too, once you're upgraded a little bit. The only thing is your recovery afterward, you're pretty much wide open, so you want to use that carefully. It looks like some of the enemies just ignore you when you're in that too. That's pretty cool. Okay, let's test out the abilities of this path this time. Okay. So, the other path was more centric towards just Donkey Kong on his own. This one is better in Super Donkey Kong mode. And the reason for that is mainly because of the healing. Let me get hit on purpose here. So yeah, you constantly get healed and it's awesome. Get hit again. So yeah, let me transform and yeah, you heal like, yeah, 105. Well, it might be different depending on your level, but you do heal every few seconds or so. And yeah, as you saw, the melee combos in this path are really, really good. I mean, you could still use him as Donkey Kong, but, you know, like the other path in Super Donkey Kong mode, it's just not as good as if you chose the path that's, you know, more focused on that. There's that one. Steamrolled through that guy. Okay, here's the next round. Let's build up Diddy Kong here. There we go. Yeah, this right here, the girders are really, really useful, but they kind of fall in random spots, so enemies can attack you while you're just stomping on the ground like that. Look at Diddy Kong, he just took out all the guys I wasn't even paying attention to. Actually, yeah, this barrel serves as a nice getaway as well. And since you steamroll through enemies, you can, like, avoid some attacks, too. Oh, I'm over here. Nope, I'm over here. That's it. Oh, he's level 20 now. Okay, so the top path is called Powder Keg Power. I couldn't remember the names of them off the top of my head because you can't see them until you're like at this screen. And the bottom one's Pointy Preparations. So between the two, which one would I recommend? Well, honestly, I'd recommend both of them. They're both really good. Like I said in the combat section of this video, if you like using Donkey Kong more, then go with the top path. But if you like going into Super Donkey Kong mode more, then definitely pick the bottom path. But if I had to choose between the two, I would pick the bottom path. And the main reason for that is the healing in the Super Donkey Kong mode. It keeps him alive, and it's like extremely useful. Any moves that can heal your Skylander are just really amazing. But like I said, I do recommend both, but if I had to choose one, it would be Pointy Preparations.
Barrel Blaster.
Okay, we're just going to take a quick look at the different upgrades for the Barrel Blaster. These are the different horns: Howling Horn, Treetop Whistle Horn, Factory Valve Horn, and Old School Sound Horn. Okay, and these are the specialty mods. These change the front of the vehicle. So Jungle Tree Plates are the default ones. Batty Crushers, Banana Coal Catcher, and Bonus Stage Boosters. So when you equip one of these on the vehicle, it changes the stats. Some of them are a little bit more noticeable, others maybe not so much. Like this one here, armor plus 150, weight 5, but this one's just plus 5 in acceleration and handling, which you know, do make a bit of a difference, but maybe it's not as noticeable. Okay, and here are the performance mods: Barrel Bracer, which is the default one, Steel Drum Driver, Kong Crafted Engine, and Simian Street Burners. And these are the weapons, which I will show in a moment. Press Y and blast your enemies with a heavy-duty barrel cannon. Press X to surround yourself with spiked barrel mines.
Okay, let's check out some quick gameplay of the Barrel Blaster, and then I'll end the video. I'm just going to show what it can do in this area over here. So this is the combat test area. You can actually drive around here in a land vehicle and collect some gear bits. You can also test out the weaponry. Yep, you can even spawn some enemies. The Y button launches a series of barrels that home in on enemies, so that's really, really useful. And then if you hit the X button, it surrounds the vehicle with barrels, and you can run into enemies with these. You can also let go of X, and they'll disperse and hit any enemies nearby. Okay, that should be the last guy. There we go. So yeah, I do enjoy the Barrel Blaster. I think it's one of the better land vehicles, because it's pretty strong, and I like the attacks. Okay, before the end of the video, I wanted to show the Barrel Blaster's Skystone in Skystone's Overdrive. So this is it right here. It has 4 health and 3 attack, which is actually pretty good. The special ability of the Barrel Blaster Skystone is really good. It heals 8 and all friendly stones by 1. So if there's an ally Skystone that took some damage, it'll heal that by 1, and it'll heal the player by 8. So let's play it and check it out. So yeah, a very, very useful Skystone. It's one of my favorite vehicle Skystones. Overdrive ready. Okay, and that is going to be it for the first episode of my Skylanders feature. Hopefully you enjoyed the video, and if you did, please show support by leaving a like. It helps me know if there's interest in the series, and if there is interest in the series, I have another episode already planned. And I will end this video with a preview for the next featured character. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I will see you next time.
Super Shot Stealth Elf.